Hello, I'm Maruk Saeed, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
Polygenic inheritance explained: traits, examples, and environmental impact. Table of contents. Introduction to polygenic inheritance. Characteristics of polygenic inheritance. Examples of polygenic inheritance in human. Examples of polygenic inheritance in plants. Environmental effect on polygenic inheritance. Importance of polygenic inheritance. Polygenic traits and oligogenic traits. Introduction to polygenic inheritance. Polygenic inheritance refers to a phenotypic character determined by the additive effect of more than one gene on a single trait. It is also commonly known as quantitative inheritance or multiple gene inheritance. Traits such as height, skin pigmentation, eye color, hair color, milk production, and egg production are examples of phenotypic characteristics influenced by polygenic inheritance in both plants and animals. Many traits and phenotypic characters are inherited through the combined action of many alleles located at different loci, which is characteristic of polygenic inheritance. This type of inheritance is controlled by more than one gene, and the dominant alleles have a cumulative effect, with each dominant allele contributing a part or unit to the overall trait. The collective effect of multiple genes results in a significant phenotypic outcome, whereas the impact of a single gene on the phenotype is minimal. The complete expression of the trait occurs only when all dominant alleles involved are present. The father of phenotypic inheritance is Kohlerunter. Polygenic inheritance was discovered by Nilsson, Ale, and East through their work on kernel color in wheat. A gene that has a small effect on a phenotype when combined with other genes is referred to as a polygene. Two types of genes or alleles are involved in polygenic inheritance: contributing alleles, which contribute to continuous variation; non-contributing alleles, which do not contribute to continuous variation.
If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated.
Characteristics of polygenic inheritance. Each gene involved in polygenic inheritance has a very small effect, making individual gene effects difficult to detect, but their combined effect is significant and easily observable. Each allele contributes in an additive and cumulative manner to the overall phenotype. Multiple genes produce an equal effect on the trait. A single phenotypic character or specific trait is controlled by more than one gene, and all such genes involved are non-allelic. Due to the complex nature of polygenic inheritance, predicting the phenotype is challenging. Polygenic inheritance is often analyzed statistically to estimate population parameters. It results in continuous variation of the phenotype for a given trait. Environmental factors, along with the collective action of many genes, contribute to continuous phenotypic variation. Each gene contributes a certain degree of effect, and the presence of more dominant genes leads to a more pronounced expression of the trait. Hence, quantitative inheritance is also known as polygenic inheritance. The expression of the trait becomes more prominent with the addition of several alleles. Polygenic inheritance is also referred to as cumulative inheritance because the phenotype is determined by the number of dominant alleles present.
Monogenic inheritance follows Mendelian patterns and can be predicted using phenotypic ratios, but polygenic inheritance does not follow Mendelian ratios. Polygenic inheritance is distinct from the concept of multiple alleles. For example, human blood groups involve multiple alleles, where three or more alleles occupy the same locus, such as the ABO blood grouping system, which is governed by three alleles. In the F2 generation, the distribution of different phenotypes due to polygenic inheritance typically follows a bell-shaped curve. Eye color. Eye color, though traditionally believed to be determined by a few key genes, actually involves the interaction of multiple genes. Variations within eye color shades, especially blue, green, and hazel, are influenced by complex genetic mechanisms. The OCA2 and HERC2 genes play a major role in determining eye color. Additional genes also contribute to subtle differences in eye color intensity and specific shades. Human height. Human height is a polygenic trait influenced by three genes, each with two alleles, resulting in a total of six alleles, three dominant and three recessive. A person with all dominant alleles is typically tall, while a person with all recessive alleles is generally short. Height distribution in humans follows a normal, bell-shaped distribution curve. One end represents the tall population. The other end represents the short population. The middle portion represents individuals of average height. A recent scientific study identified that over 400 genes are associated with variations in human height. Examples of polygenic inheritance in plants. Kernel color in wheat is an example of polygenic inheritance in plants. Cob length in maize is influenced by multiple genes and exhibits polygenic inheritance. Length of the corolla in tobacco is also controlled by several genes, making it a polygenic trait. Kernel color of the wheat. Nielsen-Ehle, 1908, provided the first experimental evidence of polygenic inheritance through his work on the kernel color of wheat. The kernel color in wheat is determined by three independently assorting pairs of alleles. A dark red kernel is produced when all three dominant alleles are present. Capital A, capital A, capital B, capital B, capital C, capital C. A white kernel results from having all recessive alleles, small, A, small, A, small, B, small, B, small, C. When crossed, the F1 generation has a genotype capital A, small A, capital B, small B, capital C, small, C, producing an intermediate red color. In the F2 generation, a phenotypic ratio of 1 white to 63 red, with various shades of red, is observed. Environmental effect on polygenic inheritance. Polygenic inheritance in humans and other organisms is strongly influenced by environmental factors. Various environmental conditions or agents can regulate gene function, leading to variations in how genes are expressed. Genes can be switched on or off depending on the surrounding environmental conditions. The range of phenotypes that arise from a given genotype under different environmental conditions is known as the norm of reaction. Environmental factors affect gene expression in traits such as human height, skin color, intelligence, depression, and schizophrenia. Phenotypic expression is shaped by both genetics, nature, and environment, nurture. A well-known example is the hereditary disorder phenylketonuria. In phenylketonuria, the alleles of the phenylketonuria gene lack an enzyme needed to break down the amino acid phenylalanine. As a result, phenylalanine accumulates in the body to toxic levels. A strict diet low in phenylalanine from an early age can prevent or reduce the harmful effects of phenylketonuria. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Importance of polygenic inheritance. Polygenic inheritance determines quantitative traits rather than qualitative traits and does not show sharp segregation like typical Mendelian traits. It leads to continuous variation of traits within a population rather than clear-cut categories. The polygenic theory helps explain the relationship between continuous variation and discontinuous variation, as well as between biometrical and genetic variation. Polygenic variation, also known as polygenesis, contributes to population variance and the evolution of species. This concept is also referred to as the theory of polygeny in the context of evolution. The variation resulting from polygenic inheritance is key to adaptive changes, which may differ according to the specific needs and environmental demands of individuals or species. Polygenic traits and oligogenic traits. Polygenic traits. Polygenic traits are controlled by multiple genes. The genes involved may be located close together or on separate chromosomes. These traits do not follow Mendel's laws of inheritance. The expression of each individual gene is minor and often difficult to detect. Polygenic traits show a range of continuous variation in the population. They are significantly influenced by environmental factors. Mean, variance, and covariance are statistical parameters used to evaluate these traits in populations. The genes involved exhibit an additive effect, where each contributes a small part to the overall phenotype. Segregation into distinct classes is not possible due to continuous variation. Examples of polygenic traits include skin color, eye color, height, and hair color. Oligogenic traits. Oligogenic traits are controlled by a few genes that have large effects on the expression of the trait. These traits are important in breeding programs and the improvement of various crops. The expression of individual genes is detectable in oligogenic traits. Some oligogenic traits confer plant resistance to diseases, such as resistance to rust in eucalyptus, rice sheath blight, and pea diseases. The genes involved in oligogenic traits exhibit a non-additive effect. Oligogenic traits typically show discontinuous variation, distinct categories. Segregation into classes is possible, allowing for clear distinctions in trait expression. Environmental factors do not significantly influence oligogenic traits. Ratios and frequencies are used as statistical parameters to evaluate these traits in populations. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon button. Thank you.